from now, we'll all be gone. All our friends will move away, and they're going to better places, but our friends will be gone away.
16 says, God is love, and whoever abides in love abides in God, and God abides in him. God gave us marriage for the full expression of the love between a man and a woman. In marriage, a woman and a man belong to each other, and with affection and tenderness, freely give themselves to each other. God gave us marriage as a holy mystery, in which a man and a woman are joined together and become one, just as Christ is one with the church. In marriage, husband and wife are called to a new way of life. Created, ordered, and blessed by God, this way of life must not be entered carelessly or from selfish motives, but responsibly and prayerfully, and we know that is true today. We rejoice that marriage is given by God, blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and sustained by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, let marriage be held in honor by all. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for today. Many have prayed for this, but you are the one who orchestrated this beautiful story. A story of two people who spent close to a decade as dear friends until in your perfect providential timing caused them to fall deeply in love with each other. Jesus, you gave your blessing at the wedding in Cana of Galilee. Be present here this day as these two come to be joined as wife and husband. Let your Holy Spirit rest upon them so that with steadfast love they may honor the promises they make this day through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. One of the greatest influences in life and marriage is the influence of your parents. And both Seth and Janessa have had the privilege and blessing of growing up with loving, faithful parents. It is their desire to have their parents' blessing and pledge of support for this sacred marriage. So I have a question for the parents. Put your hand on Seth's shoulder there. Like you like him, there you go. This is beautiful. My question is this: will you, the parents of Seth and Janessa, give the blessing to this new family? Will you support it with your love and care? If so, say, we will with the help of God. Amen. You guys remember, they said that. Okay. You guys can sit down. And Seth and Janessa, I have some questions for you. Seth, brother. Will you receive Janessa as your wife and bind yourself to her in the covenant of marriage? Will you promise to love and honor her in true devotion, to rejoice with her in times of gladness, to grieve with her in times of sorrow, and to be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I will with the help of God. Janessa, soon to be sister, will you receive Seth as your husband and bind yourself to him in the covenant of marriage? Will you promise to love and honor him in true devotion, to rejoice with him in times of gladness, to grieve with him in times of sorrow, and to be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I will with the help of God. Congregation, real quickly, can you guys just kind of turn and look at your friends and family? Sometimes in these ceremonies, we miss moments like this just to see the friends and the family and the loved ones and the way that these stories intersect. So I have a question for you. Will you, friends and family, who are here today because you've been a valuable piece of Seth and Janessa's story, I invite you to answer these questions of love and support. Will you, their friends and family, support this couple now and in the years ahead? If so, say, we will. Amen. Today, as I was thinking about what to share with you two, or more importantly, maybe what not to share, I wanted to start by just reminding you of how special this moment is. Seth, you've shared with me that Janessa gets you. She understands and balances your empathy deficiency. She's more emotional, empathetic, and compassionate. She shows grace more and encourages you to be more thoughtful, and she is fiercely loyal. She courageously loves Jesus and follows his lead, and she loves your love for ministry. She doesn't need you, yet she loves you. She gives you more of a desire to understand justice, and she challenges your complacency, and you get to love her for the rest of your life. Janessa, Seth knows you completely and accepts you. He is the first person you go to for everything. Seth is an includer. He balances your need for a plan and your difficulty with meeting new people with his go with the flow. It's not the end of the world if things don't go a certain way. Outlook in life. And his constant reminder that people are more important than details. Although he struggles with empathy, he has a soft, genuine, selfless, and kind heart. He helps you look at things with a different perspective, lens, and isn't afraid of disagreement. He loves Jesus completely and strives to live like him, and you get to love him for the rest of your life. The song you walk down the aisle to right now says, "One look at you, and my whole life falls in line. I prayed for you before I called you mine." We all know that to be very true. "Oh, I can't believe it's true sometimes. Oh, I can't believe it's true. I get to love you, and it's the best thing that I'll ever do." As you think about this, I would challenge this song in one way by reading to you John chapter 15. This was the verse we looked at together as we thought about what we wanted to reflect on. It is this. This is the words of Jesus. He said, "As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now remain, abide in my love. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for his friends." Seeing that first verse, I encourage you, the most important thing is that you get to love Christ. And most importantly, he loves you. And as you remain in his love, he will teach you how to love each other better. And this kind of love is the love, this is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his son as an atoning sacrifice. And this is the love you get to have for each other. So I encourage you to embrace the joy of Christ's love for you, and then to love one another as Christ loved you. And we see this in you. Behind you, I see a lot of heads nodding yes, because they know that this is the kind of love you have. With that said, it's time for you. You've prepared some vows. So if you can face each other. You haven't memorized, right? Just kidding. Janessa, you will go first.
preparing for today, I reflected on all the time we've known each other, and I was struck first by... Take a breath. How much your friendship means to me. Since I can remember, you've been the first person I could go to when anything good, bad, or funny happened in my life. You've always been there for me. I knew this was going to happen. You know me completely and fully accept me, while still always challenging me to be better. You're my home and my safe place. I love you for so many reasons. I love you for your kindness and genuine selflessness. You've always been my biggest support, and you challenge me to be more sacrificial every day by your example. I love your heart for ministry and how important your own faith is to you. You desire to share Jesus' love, and you strive to be more like him every day. I love that we challenge each other in our faiths, and that I can see how we've grown together through the years. I love that you know not to talk to me before coffee. You know when to let me verbally process without giving me answers, and you make me laugh every day. Being long distance has taught me a lot about us, but mostly it's shown me how right everything feels when we're together. I vow to always put you and our marriage first, to respect you as you do me, and to always remember that we're on the same team. I promise to seek reconciliation over being right, and to seek compromise over my own way. Lastly, I vow to commit myself to your holiness, and to eagerly help you know, love, and serve God in deeper ways. I love you, and I'm better because of you.
Janessa, you are my best friend, the most beautiful woman I've ever met, inside and out, and the person who understands me the most. I love your heart for justice and helping those who are helpless. You love Jesus and have the courage and faith to go wherever he leads you, even if it's difficult. Thanks for being patient with me and not giving up on me, even though it took me forever to realize how much I love and need you. I love your independence. You don't need a man to complete you, yet you chose to love me anyways. I respect your discipline and what a hard worker you are. Everything you have, you've earned. I love that we have so much in common, like baseball. TV shows, brunch, loving Jesus, music, sarcasm, and comedy. I promise to always be faithful to you, to try to put you first always, to listen and empathize with you, even when I don't understand. I love that you get me and understand that I don't know how to handle emotions and can be kind of a bitter Beardsley. I promise to be okay with emotions and to let you cry whenever you want. And I vow to always think the best of you and assume you also think the best of me. I vow to pray with you and for you and to put Jesus at the center of our relationship. I vow to apologize when I hurt you and ask for forgiveness when I mess up. To be present with you and to give you all the quality time that you need. I thank God for you every day and am so blessed that I get to marry the best woman I know and my very best friend.
Rings serve as a sign and reminder to you, not a sign of ownership or possession, but a covenant, a gift. My hope is that you will continue to give and receive like you are today for the rest of your lives together. Seth, you can go first. There you go. So repeat this vow to me as you place it on Jesus. I, Seth,
take you, Janessa, to be my wife.
I promise before God and these witnesses,
to be your loving and faithful husband,
in plenty and in want,
in joy and in sorrow,
in sickness and in health,
as long as we both shall live.
Got the right finger, good job. And Janessa, as you place the ring on Seth, repeat this after me. I, Janessa, take you, Seth, to be my husband. I promise before God and these witnesses to be your loving and faithful wife, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. Great. If you can join hands, we're reading for you. And as you join hands, just look at each other's hands here. Hold hands. It's okay. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will wipe countless tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children, hopefully lots of them. I added that. These are the hands that will help you to hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands that, even when wrinkled in age, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Let's pray. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world you have redeemed, and especially upon Seth and Janessa. Give them wisdom and devotion in their common life, that each may be to the other a strength in need, a counselor in perplexity, a comfort in sorrow, and a companion in joy. Grant that their will may be knit together in your will, and that your spirit is your spirit, that their spirit is your spirit, that they may grow in love and peace with you and each other all the days of their life. Grant them the grace, when they hurt each other, to recognize and confess their fault and to seek each other's forgiveness and yours. Make their life together a sign of Christ's love to the sinful and broken world, that unity may overcome estrangement, forgiveness heal guilt, and joy conquer despair. Give them such fulfillment of their mutual love that they may reach out in concern for others. Give them, if it is your will, the gift of children and the wisdom to bring them up to know you, to love you, and to serve you. Grant that all who have witnessed these vows today may find their lives strengthened, and that all who are married may depart with their own promises renewed. Enrich with your grace all husbands and wives, parents and children, that loving and supporting one another, they may serve those in need and be a sign of your kingdom. Grant that the bonds by which all children are united to one another may be transformed by your spirit, that your peace and justice may fill the earth through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The first thing that Janessa and Seth wanted to do as a married couple was to take communion together, a sign of the abiding love of the Heavenly Father. As Seth and Janessa take their first communion together as a couple, I encourage you to reflect on the significance and beauty of this moment, and when they are through, to join us in singing of the deep abiding love of our Heavenly Father.
My shame that held him there until it was accomplished.
It is dying that has brought me back. I know that it is finished.
Beautiful. Seth and Janessa, having made their covenant of marriage together before God and all here present, by solemn vows with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, therefore I declare, after a really long time, that they are husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Seth, you may kiss your bride. I count it a great honor to be the first to introduce to you Seth and Janessa Beardsley. Let no one come between those whom God has joined together. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Rivers till I reach you.
Ready, one, two, three.